SpaceX has once again pushed the boundaries of what is possible in space exploration with its Starship innovation. Despite certain obstacles, Ship 33, in a remarkable display of engineering prowess, saw Super Heavy Booster 1 make a perfect landing on the Mechazilla arm for the second time. This incredible achievement heralds a bold new era for the aerospace sector. But what fate befell Ship 33? What made the B1 success such a transformative milestone? And how did SpaceX and Elon Musk react to this momentous event? Let's dive deeper into today's episode of In Our Studio. We are all eagerly awaiting Flight 7, which marks the inaugural V2 mission, featuring a slew of upgrades and new objectives, and is the first flight of 2025. The excitement is palpable, fueled by previous Starship setbacks, and SpaceX's capacity to meet these expectations only heightens the anticipation. About an hour before departure, Starbase is buzzing with activity as fueling and engine cooling procedures are underway. The company verified that the fuel payload had reached an impressive 900 metric tons, equivalent to 10.8 million pounds, highlighting the incredible efficiency of the V2 boost. As the launch approached, the water deluge system was smoothly activated, following standard protocol for SpaceX launches. Then, at exactly 3:37 p.m. Central Time, SpaceX released a revised schedule just hours before launch. The ignition of 33 Super Heavy engines propelled the seventh iteration of Starship into the cosmos. The projected thrust continued to be incredible, exceeding 7,000 tons, equivalent to about 16 million pounds. During the ascent, we observed the engines operating consistently, allowing the rocket to exceed max Q. At T plus 2 minutes and 35 seconds, the Super Heavy engines shut down, leading to the activation of the ship's engines. The efficient hot staging mechanism facilitated a smooth separation of the two stages, marking another milestone in the mission. From that point on, both stages began their respective journeys. However, the spotlight was inevitably focused on the Super Heavy, ready to be captured by Mechazilla's arm. At T plus 3 minutes and 5 seconds, the hot staging ejection procedure is executed. Unlike previous instances where this procedure was documented remotely, SpaceX strategically adjusted the camera angle to focus on the booster's top and its structure. This new perspective produces some incredible new footage, most notably showing the impressive view of the Super Heavy's methane tank pipes. Please provide the text you would like rewritten. Truly magnificent. Building on these achievements, SpaceX advanced the booster landing procedure, leveraging the capabilities of the engines and grid fins. Following the detachment of the hot stage, Super Heavy progressed into the transonic phase. At T plus 6 minutes and 19 seconds, the bottom camera activated, providing us with an additional perspective of the illuminated engine compartment, reminiscent of our earlier observations at V12, and heralding the hopeful prospect of a successful landing. As anticipated, that success came to fruition. At T plus 6 minutes and 31 seconds, when Super Heavy ascended to an altitude of 1 kilometer and attained a velocity of 1,238 kilometers per hour, all gimbal engines within the middle and inner rings activated, enhancing both acceleration and navigational capabilities. This occasion presented a delightful surprise, particularly following the separation sequence at T plus 2 minutes and seconds when Super Heavy reignited its engines. However, one engine within the central ring failed to achieve ignition. That failure initially raised apprehension, as it implied that an error may have occurred. Nevertheless, the landing sequence transpired seamlessly, with all 13 engines, in conjunction with the previously referenced middle ring engine, playing a pivotal role in both deceleration and navigation. At T plus 6 minutes and 37 seconds, the middle engines were deactivated, resulting in the continued operation of only the three inner engines, which proceeded to effectively decrease the vehicle's speed. At this juncture, the destination emerged distinctly before us, the tower, equipped with a majestic arm designed to ensnare the Super Heavy. Through the synergistic interplay of engine thrust and grit fins, Super Heavy methodically approached the tower, achieving a flawless alignment with the chopstick precisely at T plus 6 minutes and 6 seconds. The chopstick deftly converged to firmly secure the booster. At T plus 6 minutes and 5 seconds, the engines were deactivated, and Super Heavy was securely stabilized on the chopstick. The landing was executed with impeccable precision. Upon landing, there were no signs of fire or any other complications. In contrast to the B-12 flight, which experienced a post-landing fire resulting in minor damage to the extensive system, this occasion proceeded seamlessly without incident. Moreover, the communication antenna system, which had previously experienced a malfunction during Flight 6 leading to a cancellation, operated flawlessly this time, facilitating the successful endeavor to retrieve the booster. Elon Musk swiftly expressed his enthusiasm by tweeting images alongside the message, "We successfully captured the rocket." This moment served as yet another affirmation of the remarkable prowess of the SpaceX team, who persistently enhanced and perfected their designs by leveraging insights gained from prior challenges. This capacity for adaptation and enhancement has been pivotal in SpaceX's ascent to prominence and its sustained success. Super Heavy B1 represents the second Starship booster to be successfully retrieved, accomplishing this feat through the utilization of SpaceX's distinctive Mechazilla arm. The seamless landing clearly demonstrates that SpaceX has perfected the technique of capturing the Super Heavy. Let us express our endorsement by commenting, "Well done, SpaceX," in the section below. Please remember to like and subscribe to remain informed about the thrilling developments in SpaceX's journey. With every triumphant launch, we advance towards a future characterized by reusable rockets and sustainable space exploration. Undoubtedly, the pinnacle of achievement lies ahead. Although the Super Heavy booster is performing commendably, attention is now focused on the Starship spacecraft, which seems to have encountered a considerable problem during this flight. In the wake of the successful capture of Super Heavy booster B1, observers remarked on the conspicuous absence of a seamless transition to the camera feed monitoring Starship's trajectory. At T+8:26, telemetry data for ship 33 indicated that its altitude and speed remained static at 16 kilometers and 21,317 kilometers per hour, respectively. This sudden cessation prompted immediate inquiries regarding the status of the spacecraft. It implies that ship 33 probably experienced a catastrophic failure, leading to the engagement of the flight termination system. SpaceX verified this via a post on X, indicating that Starship encountered a rapid, unscheduled disassembly during its ascent phase prior to ignition. Elon Musk offered further insights, indicating that there is preliminary evidence suggesting a significant oxygen and fuel leak occurred in the compartment above the ship's engine firewall, sufficient to generate pressure that exceeded the venting capacity. A meticulous analysis of the flight indicated possible indicators of concern even prior to separation. The presence of damage in the payload compartment was apparent, accompanied by flames observed in proximity to the aft flap joint following separation. These irregularities indicate that the problem may arise from design variations implemented in the most recent iteration of Starship, although SpaceX has yet to verify the precise underlying cause. The company assured the public in a statement that teams will persist in analyzing data from today's flight test to gain a deeper understanding of the underlying cause. Notwithstanding the setback, this outcome is improbable to substantially hinder SpaceX's momentum. Both the organization and its CEO underscore the significance of insights gained from such evaluations. SpaceX's statement emphasized that success from a test of this nature is derived from the insights gained. Today's flight will contribute significantly to enhancing the reliability of Starship. Musk resonated with this notion, tweeting, "While success may be unpredictable, entertainment is assured." The incident has prompted a formal inquiry by the Federal Aviation Administration. Although this may cause delays in future launches, the synergy of SpaceX's nimbleness and recent advancements in FAA protocols indicates that these obstacles could potentially be addressed with relative expediency. While the incident may make this specific flight far from optimal, it also presents an occasion for SpaceX to enhance Starship further, akin to their previous improvements with Super Heavy. Upon the comprehensive fulfillment of FAA requirements, SpaceX stands ready to advance with remarkable alacrity. Prototypes for the forthcoming mission, specifically Ship 3 and Booster 15, are reportedly primed and prepared for deployment. Concerning the forthcoming mission, it is anticipated that Flight 8 will once again necessitate an ocean landing for the Starship spacecraft, as SpaceX has not yet accomplished this essential test with success. Flight 9, equipped with Booster 16 and Ship 35, is expected to undertake the inaugural capture of a returning Starship. As previously disclosed, Ship 35 will incorporate enhanced landing pins to facilitate this significant milestone. Should everything proceed as intended, flight the 8th of May take place as early as late February, with flight 9 closely on its heels. Despite the inherent challenges, SpaceX continues to progress towards achieving complete reusability, which stands as a fundamental pillar of their ambitious objectives for Starship. This vehicle is engineered to transform space exploration by enhancing affordability and sustainability, thereby facilitating missions to the Moon, Mars, and further. In a recent development regarding space exploration, it seems that China's Yutu-2 rover has subtly halted its operations. Initiated in 2018 as a component of the Chang'e mission, Yutu-2 successfully touched down in the von Karman crater on January 3, 2019, and demonstrated an extraordinary operational longevity on the lunar surface. As of September 202, China announced that Yutu-2 had covered a distance of 1,613 meters. However, data from NASA's Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter presents a conflicting account. As noted by Phil Stuck, professor emeritus at the University of Western Ontario, analysis of Lunar Reconnaissance Orbiter images suggests that the rover has remained stationary since March 202. This inconsistency casts doubt on the true condition of the rover. China's update from January 2025 asserted that the rover remained operational as of September 202, complete with photographic evidence of its travel traces. Nevertheless, NASA observed that Yutu-2's traversal distances have been progressively diminishing since early 2023. As of March 202, the rover seemed to have come to a complete halt in proximity to a crater. Preliminary conjecture indicates that there are communication difficulties associated with the Chuichao satellite, which functions as a relay intermediary between Earth and the rover. Despite the replacement of its satellite, Yutu-2 continues to exhibit a stationary state, suggesting that the underlying problem may be an intrinsic issue with the rover, possibly stemming from prolonged exposure to the harsh lunar environment. As the Yutu-2 mission nears its conclusion, NASA is ramping up its efforts in lunar exploration. The Blue Ghost mission is currently underway, with additional landers such as IM-2 and Griffin scheduled for future launches. These missions, powered by SpaceX's expertise, are playing a critical role in transporting payloads to the Moon. These initiatives exemplify a revitalized dedication to winning in the effort to reestablish a human presence on the lunar surface. The global race for spaceflight continues to be highly competitive. However, NASA's progress, powered by SpaceX's innovation, could provide significant strategic advantages. In a broader perspective, these advances underscore the dynamic nature of space exploration, which includes resolving Starship issues, evaluating impacts, and anticipating future lunar missions, as humanity's search for the stars continues to be a source of inspiration. That's it for today's episode. See you next time.